My character is a young artist who turns up in Rothko's studio at the beginning, excited at the possibility of working for this titan of 20th century art. So this is a sort of amazing golden ticket opportunity. He starts working as his assistant, and their relationship deepens and develops over the course of the play. Rothko's working to create a series of murals, the Seagram, now known as the Seagram murals, for the Seagram building in New York. And the play takes place over that two-year period that he's working to create them. Ken, as a young man, is understandably overawed at first, and then he starts finding his voice a bit and finding a bit of space in the studio to express himself and to explore what art is and to challenge Rothko on a few things. It kind of goes from there.
Playing that icon of the art world is one of the icons of our acting world. Can you talk a little bit about the amazing qualities that Fred has and your relationship on this production?
I mean, I wouldn't want to sort of cheapen his many skills and talents by sort of pedestrianly delineating them as I would do. But I mean, he is the most beautiful, beautiful actor. He's someone whose work I've long admired, someone who I sort of pinch myself that I get to work with him pretty much every day. I mean, I come off stage and it's a thrill. It's a thrill to be able to do a play as good as this, and to get to, when it's just you and someone of that caliber, of that talent and of that skill, it's a real privilege. He's been so welcoming and so warm. You know, he's done this play twice before with two fantastic actors, and I haven't felt like I've been stepping into someone else's shoes. I haven't felt that I needed to do it this way, that way, or the other. He's been part of this amazing freedom that I've been given, not just by him, by Michael as well, by the whole team, who have really kind of empowered me to go and make my own thing of it. You know, have my own slant at this play and this character. So it's been a joy. I think this play has something. You're right, it is timeless, I think. Well, firstly, because it's a fantastic piece of theatre. I mean, on the page it reads incredibly, and over the rehearsal process, my relationship with it, obviously, as inevitably happens, has deepened and deepened, but you realise how much is there. It's a really incredible piece. So I think that's one reason. The other thing is it's asking us about what art is and why art matters and why... What we owe to art. You know, Rothko talks about giving his paintings care and attention, the same care and attention that he gives them. And I think there's something very profound in that, in our relationship as viewers, as audience members, as listeners, as whatever, that it's a two-way street. Art exists in that exchange between the work and the person consuming it. I don't mean that in a sort of financial sense. But I think also this production... I think this play is very timeless. Is very timely, and hopefully this production as well, because it speaks about. Well, I think talking about why art is important at a time where you have lots of cuts to the public sector and to arts funding is important. That is a dialogue that needs to be out there, and I think this play makes a very eloquent case for the importance of art. I think the other thing is that this play explores what happens when two generations come together with different perspectives, with different priorities, different contexts, and what happens in the exchange. And I think in 2018, that's a very big thing. So hopefully audiences will come and find those things resonant and relevant to the society we live in today. We're on at the Wyndham's Theatre on the Charing Cross Road, and we run till the 28th of July. So please do come.